नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयत्मुदीरये नष्टप्रायेष्व भद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्टिकी कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। ऋषेव निर्गमे कंसो यदुन्मत्त्वा सुरानिति देवक्या गर्भसंभूतं विष्णुं च स्ववधं प्रति देवकीं वासुदेवं च निग्रय निगडैग्रहे जातं जातमहन्पुत्रं तयोरजनशङ्कया। ऋषेव निर्गमे कंसो यदुन्मत्त्वा सुरानिति देवक्या गर्भसंभूतं विष्णुं च स्ववदं प्रति देवकीं वासुदेवं च निग्रहे निगडैग्रहे जातं जातमहन्पुत्रं तयोरजनशङ्खया। डायरेक्ट सो लीव द ट्रांसलेशन एंड परपट डायरेक्टली वर्ड टू वर्ड विनिंग ऋषे ऑफ द ग्रेट सेज नारद निर्गमे ऑन द डिपार्चर आफ्टर गिविंग इन्फॉर्मेशन कंसः कंसा यदुन ऑल द मेंबर्स ऑफ द यदु डायनेस्टी मत्वा थिंकिंग ऑफ सुरान एज डेमिगॉड्स इति दस देवक्या ऑफ देवकी गर्भसंभूतम द चिल्ड्रन बॉर्न फ्रॉम द वूम विष्णु एक्सेप्टिंग एज विष्णु च एंड स्ववदम प्रति फियरिंग हिज ओन डेथ फ्रॉम विष्णु देवकीं देवकी वासुदेवं च एंड हर हस्बैंड वसुदेव निग्रया अरेस्टिंग निगदई बाय आयन शैकल्स गृहे कन्फाइंड एट होम जातम जातम ईच वन हु वॉज बॉर्न वन आफ्टर अनादर अहन किल्ड पुत्रां द सन्स तयो और वसुदेव एंड देवकी अजन शंखया विद द डाउट दैट दे वुड बी विष्णु। ट्रांसलेशन एंड परपट बाय डिवाइन ग्रेस श्री भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद। आफ्टर द डिपार्चर ऑफ द ग्रेट सेंट नारद कंसा थॉट दैट ऑल द मेंबर्स ऑफ द यदु डायनेस्टी वर डेमिगॉड्स एंड दैट एनी ऑफ द चिल्ड्रन बॉर्न फ्रॉम द वूम ऑफ देवकी माइट बी विष्णु फियरिंग दिस डेथ Kamsa arrested Vasudev and Devaki and chained them with iron shackles. Suspecting each of the children to be Vishnu, Kamsa killed them one after another because of the prophecy that Vishnu would kill him. Purport. Srila Jiva Goswami in his notes on his words has mentioned how Narada Muni gave Kamsa this information. This incident is described in the Harivamsa. Narada Muni went to see Kamsa by providence and Kamsa received him very well. Narada therefore informed him that anyone of the sons of Devaki might be Vishnu. Because Vishnu was to kill him, Kamsa should not spare any of Devaki's children, Narad Muni advised. Narada's intention was that Kamsa, by killing the children, would increase his sinful activities so that Krishna would soon appear to kill him. Upon receiving the instructions of Narada Muni, Kamsa killed all the children of Devaki one after another. The word Ajana Shankhaya indicates that Lord Vishnu never takes birth, Ajana, and that he therefore appeared as Krishna taking birth just as a human being. Manushim Tanum Ashritam. Kamsa attempted to kill all the babies born of Devaki and Vasudev, although he knew that if Vishnu were born, he would not be killed. Actually, it came to pass that when Vishnu appeared as Krishna, Kamsa would not kill him. Rather, as foretold, it was he who killed Kamsa. One who knows in the truth Krishna, who takes his birth transcendentally, acts to kill the demons but is never killed. When one perfectly understands Krishna in this way, through the medium of Shastra, one becomes immortal as the Lord says in the Bhagavad Gita, Janma karma cha me divyam ayam yogati tattvataha taktva deham punar janma naiti mahamati swarjuna. One who knows the transcendental nature of my appearance and activities does not, upon leaving the body, takes his birth again in the material world, but attains my eternal abode, O Arjuna. 67th verse. Mataram pitaram bhratun sarvansha suhrat tatsata grantihi asutrupto labdha rajan prayasho vibhu rajana prayasho bhuvihi. Translations and purport. Kings greedy of sense gratification on this earth almost always kill their enemies indiscriminately. To satisfy their own whims, they may kill anyone who, even their mothers, fathers, brothers, or friends. Purport. We have seen in the history of India that Aurangzeb killed his brother and nephews and imprisoned his father to fulfill political ambitions. There have been many similar instances, and Kamsa was the same type of king. Kamsa did not hesitate to kill his nephews and imprison his sister and his father. For the demons to do such thing is not astonishing. Nonetheless, although Kamsa was a demon, he was aware that Lord Vishnu cannot be killed. And thus, he attained salvation. Even partial understanding of the activities of Lord Vishnu makes one eligible for salvation. Kamsa knew a little about Krishna, that he could not be killed, and therefore he attained salvation, although he thought of Vishnu, Krishna, as an enemy. What then is to be said of one who knows Krishna perfectly from the descriptions of Shastras like Bhagavad Gita? It is therefore the duty of everyone to read Bhagavad Gita and understand Krishna perfectly. This will make one's life successful.
जन्माद्ययस्य यतन्वया इतरतश्चार्तेष्व अभिज्ञा स्वराट् तेन ब्रह्मरथयादिकवये मुयन्ति यत् सूरया तेजोवारिमृदां यथा विनिमयो यत्र त्रिसर्गो मृषा धाम्ना स्वेन सदा निरस्तकुहकं सत्यं परं धीमहि धर्मा प्रोजित कैतवत्र परमो निर्मत्सरानां सतां वेद्यं वास्तवमत्र वस्तु शिवदं तापोत्रयनूलनं श्रीमत भागवते महामुनि कृते किं वा परेरिश्वरा सद्यो हृदय वृद्यत्र कृतिभिः शुश्रूषुभिस्तक्षणात् निगमकल्पतरोर्गलितं फलं शुकमुखादमृतद्रव्य संयुतं पिबत भागवतं रसमालयं मुहुरवो रसिका भुवि भावुका. ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनं शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः. मुखं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंगयते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे श्री गुरुं विनतारिणं परमानंदमाधवं नमोम विष्णुपदाय कृष्ण पृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे नित्यानंदमहं नौमि सर्वानंदकरं परं हरिनामाप्रदं देवं अवदूता शिरोमणिं आनंदलीलामय विग्रहाय हेमांब दिव्य छवि सुंदराय तस्मै महाप्रेम रसा प्रदाय चैतन्य चंद्राय नमो नमस्ते। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। हो गोविंदा। सो आई एम नॉट वेरी मच प्रिपेयर्ड बिकॉज आई वॉज बीन टोल्ड इन द मॉर्निंग टू गिव दिस क्लास, सो प्लीज फॉरगिव मी। So here in this verse we can find that great sage Narada, he came to Kamsa. Very unusual, but we often see personality like Narad Muni, he likes meeting demons. And Narad Muni is the greatest of the devotees and he likes to meet the greatest of the enemies. So Narad Muni, if you find out about Narad Muni is a very special personality, and you will find him in everywhere, in every Purana, in every scriptures, you will find His Holiness Naradji. We know very well that in previous life, Narad Muni was a maid, son of a maid servant, and he perfected his life by associating with Mahabhagavatas. So he is actually one of the principal devarshis, and he is among the sages among the demigods. And if you see, he is a son of Brahma, and he has initiated many great personalities. He is very, very famous for initiating big personalities. He initiated Prahlad Maharaj, Dhruva Maharaj, and many other celebrated devotees of the Supreme Lord. He even initiated the author of all the scriptures, Vyasadev. Unko nahi choda. He even initiated Vedavyasi. And from Vyasadev, Madhvacharya was initiated, and in this way our Madhva Sampradaya was born. And our Gaudiya Sampradaya also comes in this line. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu belongs to Madhva Sampradaya. Therefore, Brahma, Narada, Vyasa, Madhva, Chaitanya, and all the Goswamis also belong to the same disciplic succession, which is Brahma, Madhva, Gaudiya Sampradaya. In the Bhagavatam, we can see how Prahlad Maharaj was instructed while he was in the womb of the mother. Now this is initiation happens. Usually when the disciple is matured and he gives initiation, but Narad Muni is so exceptional that he goes and initiates people in the womb also. So this is the exceptional feature of Srila Narad Muni. Now he is such an eternal spaceman that he has a passport visa for traveling to all the places across throughout the creation of the Supreme Lord. There is not a single place in the whole of the creation of the Supreme Lord where Narad Muni cannot go. If you want to see him, the topmost of the planet is Golok Vrindavan. You can see Narad Muni in Brahad Bhagavatam. You will see, and if you want to see him in the places of Kamsa and Hiranyakashipu, you will often see him there also. When everybody was in fear, even to chant the name of Hiranyakashipu, Narad Muni used to go very often to Hiranyakashipu. And he used to say, Jai Hiranyakashipu. He used to often say that. It is said in the writings of the Acharyas that Brahma and Lord Shiva were also very afraid of Hiranyakashipu. And they used to send they used to send gifts to Hiranyakashipu. I'm not saying this. I read in the Tikas of the Acharyas, and just to maintain good relationship with Hiranyakashipu. They used to send him gifts, you know, be happy. You know. So, Narad Muni, he can travel to any place, anywhere in no time. That's a speciality of Narad Muni. And now here, if we can see that Narad Muni, he visits Kamsa. Very unusual. What business Narad Muni has to do with Kamsa? But still, Narad Muni visits Kamsa to give him some information. What is that information? Sarve vai devata praya ubhayo ropi bharata gyatayo bandhu surodo yecha kansam anuvrataha. So, Narad Muni went to inform Kamsa that ubhayo, that both these associates of Narada, so both of Nanda Maharaj and Vasudev, are actually devata praya, are actually inhabitants of heaven. This confidential information, which was kept very, very confidential in the heavenly planets, and nobody knows about that, that this is all the setting of the demigods and the Supreme Lord to kill Kamsa. But that most secret thing, Narad Muni comes and gives, leaks to Kamsa. Now a meeting happens, and it is expected that all the members of the meeting must keep this information most confidential. But that most crucial point of the discussion, the agenda point, Narad Muni takes it out and goes and informs to whom? Against whom the decision has been made. That, my dear Kamsa, you don't know that the demigods and the Supreme Lord Vishnu has made a big trap to kill all the demons. Because you all demons are like a burden on this earth, and now there is an arrangement being made where all of you will be killed. And so this Vasudev, this Devaki, this Nanda Maharaj, this Yashoda, and all their associates, do you know who are they? And do you know people who are serving you, people who are following you? Who are they? Who? They're all demigods. And Narad Muni informs this and goes. Yeah. So now, we might not find, Krishna's pastimes are mentioned at many different places. Srimad Bhagavatam, because Shukadeva Goswami has very limited time, whatever he spoke to Maharaj Parikshit. But many incidences related to same incidents, some additional things are mentioned in different Puranas. Like in Harivamsa. So this incident is in detail, is explained in Harivamsa. So, now, a similar thing happened in Ramayana also. So Dasharatha Maharaj felt that Lord Ramchandra should be, now Lord Rama should be enthroned as a king. So Dasharatha immediately went to ask Vasishthaji that what should be done, what is the best time for installing Lord Rama on the throne. He said, whenever you do that, that is auspicious time for him. Whenever you do that activity, that is auspicious. Not that look for an auspicious day and do that activity. No. Here things work little ulta, you know. When you do this enthroning, when you enthrone Lord Ramchandra as a king, that is auspicious time. So immediately, Dasharatha, he said, okay, let me do it tomorrow. Is it okay, Gurudev? He said, yes, best time, do it tomorrow, quickly. Because he knows what is going to happen. But he said, okay, if I can skip this, I don't want to see this Lord Ramchandra going to the forest. Why will a devotee want to see the Lord going away? No way. So Vasishtha was trying his best. So the demigods, they had an emergency meeting. I said, oh my God, now Lord Ramchandra is going to enthroned as a king. Now what is going to happen? If he becomes the king of the world, why will he travel and kill so many demons? Why will he? How will Ravana kidnap Sita? And how will Ravana be killed? It is very difficult because Ravana is in Lanka and he never attacked Ayodhya. There is no way. So we have to do something. So they all went to Brahma. And Brahma said, okay, we have to take help of Saraswati. So they were having discussion that on whose tongue should I reside and speak in such a way by which the whole situation changes in no time. So after deep meditation and contemplation, Saraswati decided, okay, I will choose mantra. So here also, the job which Narada Muni did in Krishna Leela, because Narada Muni wanted that Krishna should come early, and he saw that Kansa's sinful activities are not that great enough that he will be killed soon. So I have to increase the sinful activities. So Narada Muni, what he did was, to increase the sinful activities of Kamsa, he went and told, look, I have not seen a fool number one like you. And what happened? Well, Vasudev came and gave you the first son. And you, stupid person, foolish person, you gave that son back and you gave life to him. Do you know, he immediately took out a lotus. And he said, look at this lotus. Which one is the first and which one is the eighth? And that lotus has eight petals. So he showed which one is the first and which one is the eighth. You tell me. He said, if you start from here. So he just said that any personality can be Vishnu. The first or the second or the third or the fourth or the fifth or sixth, seventh, that anybody can be Vishnu. So don't take risk. So he asked Narada Muni, what should I do? Kill them all. Kill them all. Well, okay. So after Narada Muni departed, immediately Kamsa, he arrested Vasudev and Devaki and killed their sons. So similar kind of thing, even in Lord Ramchandra's pastimes, Saraswati did. So that, you know, he interrupted and made some mantra speak in such a way, mantra influenced Kaikeyi, and the whole situation was changed, and Lord Ramchandra was been sent to exile. So here the word Ajana Shankhaya indicates that Lord Vishnu never takes birth. And he therefore appears. But still we see that Krishna appears. Krishna appears, he takes birth. Ajanma ka janma, the birth of the unborn. So we need to understand the mystery behind this Krishna's appearance. And it is said also that one who knows about Krishna's activities, Krishna's birth, Krishna's pastimes, one who knows Krishna's transcendent activities, that why he takes birth, what his leelas, his pastimes are all transcendental, when someone knows that, then he, what happens to him, tyaktva deham punarajanma naiti mamiti suvarjuna. So he does not take birth, but understanding that with proper from sadhus, and just not theoretical understanding, but practically also we should understand that but this is such a amazing thing. This is such a benediction given by Lord Krishna. If one simply understands my activities, my pastimes, what happens? He will never take birth in this material world. A simple life, a simple thing, a very simple thing, but it's not that simple as it seems. So for that we have to take shelter of sadhus, and we have to hear attentively from the sadhus. In Laghu Bhagavatamrit, it is said that just as Sri Krishna is a primeval lord or unborn, his pastimes of appearance and disappearance are also beginningless. So by his own supreme will, Lord Mukunda repeatedly manifests his pastimes of appearance and disappearance in this world. And although he is unborn, he appears, and that's why he takes birth. Now, one may ask that if somebody is unborn, especially personality like the Supreme Lord, how he can take birth? When you say about birth, what we understand about birth? That it means the interaction between the having intimate association of a man and a woman. It gives birth to a baby boy or baby. So when we understand in terms of the Supreme Lord, it is not the case. The Supreme Lord, He first appears in the mind of Vasudev. If you see in this Krishna Lila, He first appears in the mind of Vasudev. And from Vasudev's mind, He was transferred to the mind of Devaki. And from there, Krishna entered in the womb. So that is the style of Krishna's appearance. He doesn't come or He doesn't take birth like ordinary people. And if you very carefully see that, many influential people in this world, they call themselves the Supreme Lord. You know, I was watching a news, and there was a very old person. He has no hair on his head, but he declared himself as his Kalki avatar. So many people believed him also. So Krishna is not like that. When Krishna takes birth in this material, when Krishna comes, what happens is that he helps his father and mother every understand about their previous life, and then he tells about his previous life also, so many things. He himself tells about his glories and activities and forms and pastimes to his own father and mother. So we have never seen such a situation in our life that somebody takes birth in a hospital, and the demigods and all the just like when Krishna takes birth in the Kamsa's jail, at that time so many demigods, they come to welcome him. Similarly, if you see that in all the incarnation, it happens that whenever the Supreme Lord is going to appear, the demigods, they first come and welcome the Lord. In whichever he has to take birth from the womb or he comes directly, but the demigods are always there to welcome him. But this is not the situation in our case. Although there might be great successful personalities in the world, but if you see their birth, it is very ordinary. And it happens in some hospitals or some places in the world, and nobody comes to welcome them. Although they might be very successful personalities now, but if you see their birth, it's very ordinary. Nobody comes to welcome them. Yeah, and they cry and all. So we need to understand that our situation, that how Krishna's birth takes place and how our birth takes place. And whenever Krishna appears, he appears with all his opulence. And when somebody like us appear, we appear completely naked and no clothes on our body. But whenever Krishna appears, he appears with all his opulence, little Shankha, little Gada, little Chakra, little Padma, and all the opulence, Srivat Sachin, and everything is there. So all the small, like a baby, but all the opulence are present. So this also we can also very intelligent person observe that this is how Krishna's Supreme Lord's appearance is, this is my appearance. So all these things, are there in the scripture so that we can understand the difference between us and the Supreme Lord. There are many reasons for why great pastimes of the Lord are mentioned in the scriptures. One of the main prominent reasons is that the conditioned souls who will hear them will get attracted. Now, now the Supreme Lord, he comes to this material world. And he comes to this material world and he performs his pastimes. And those pastimes get recorded. Now devotees of the Lord who were there during the time of the Lord, they directly get benefited. That is there. They get benefited. They see the Lord. They have darshan of the Lord. They get benefited. But what happens to those people who are coming after the Lord's appearance? So for them, all the pastimes of the Lord are recorded in the scriptural form. And then the devotees of the Lord, they sing those pastimes in the assembly of the sages, or they sing those pastimes for the general people, so that the conditioned living entity, they hear those pastimes and become devotees of the Lord. Now, what result one gets by coming in direct contact with Krishna? When Krishna was physically present, so many demons, so many people, they came in direct contact with Krishna and they got some benefit. That same benefit we derive when we hear Srimad Bhagavatam from realized souls. That same benefit is attained. That's why the Lord's pastimes and activities are recorded in the scriptures like Srimad Bhagavatam. So, if we try to understand that how Lord Krishna is unborn and he can take birth, then Laghu Bhagavatam that explains and tries to help understand this contradictory statement, that it says that one may understand that the Lord is inconceivable, full of opulence and completely spiritual, and there is no tinge of transformation in him. Nothing happens. So, whenever the Lord appears here in the material world, although he comes in the material world, but the modes of material nature cannot touch him. So, same principle it applies to the eternal associates of the Lord who come to this material world. Same principle it applies. When you say Janma Karma Chame Divyan, when it applies for the Supreme Lord, it also applies for the pure annulled devotees of the Lord. Even for them also, Janma Karma Chame Divyan principle is applicable. Even their birth, their activities are not ordinary. It might seem that in Acharya when he is born, everything in his life might be very ordinary. He gets married, and then he had kids and this and that. So many things are there in his life. He has a material degree, this and that. From external vision, it might look very ordinary. But even that personality, even that pure devotees of the Lord, they are not in the modes of material nature. They're also, because they're associated with the Supreme Lord, they're also as pure as the Supreme Lord. Even Maya cannot touch these people. Even Maya cannot touch these personalities. Although they take birth like an ordinary personalities, but their birth is transcendental. Even the Acharyas, the great Mahajanas, when they take birth, their birth is also transcendental. And just like the sun appears in the east direction, similarly these great personalities or the Supreme Lord, they also appear through the medium of this, through the great devotees, the Supreme Lord takes birth, and also the great devotees of the Lord, they also appear in the same way. So, the principal cause of the Supreme Lord's manifesting pastimes of appearance and disappearance is his desire to bless the devotees and spread the glories of his famous pastimes. So that is the main intention of the Lord's coming down, is to spread his own glories. Only Supreme Lord can do that. We should not try to imitate, spread our own glories. The Supreme Lord can definitely do that, because he comes and he, by performing his pastimes, he helps them become his devotees. So, and so here, Naraji came here, and Kamsa was informed indirectly he told about the plans of the demigods, and he helped Kamsa understand that you're about to die very soon, so plan your journey home. So we need to understand that all these pastimes which are present in the Srimad Bhagavatam, they are non-different from Sri Krishna. Each and every verse in Srimad Bhagavatam is not different from Krishna. And more we come in contact with Srimad Bhagavatam, but Srimad Bhagavatam also needs to be revealed. I have a guest in my house, and we were discussing this morning also, that how they were talking about reading so many elevated books. So there are so many elevated books of the Acharyas, and Prabhu was talking about reading those books and all. So all these books, the great books, they're also Bhagavatam actually. Because those books also, they have pastimes, activities, form, everything about the Supreme Lord. So all these books are also non-different from Srimad Bhagavatam. And the same principle applies for Srimad Bhagavatam and also for other scriptures. What? That we need to hear it from a sadhu. We need to hear and understand it from a person whose life is Srimad Bhagavatam. If we are from ourselves, from our side, if we try to academically understand Srimad Bhagavatam, then only Srimad Bhagavatam also give us the academic version of it. But Srimad Bhagavatam will not allow us to deeply enter into the pastimes of the Lord. One, because Srimad Bhagavatam is actually the window to the spiritual world. All the pastimes are live in Srimad Bhagavatam. It is not a book like Harry Potter, like, you know, concocted things are there. No, Srimad Bhagavatam is a live literature. It is a live book. If people want to enter into the pastime, this is the way. If we can absorb ourselves in the hearing, reading, and glorifying the Supreme Lord's activities and pastimes from the Srimad Bhagavatam, then gradually, by the mercy of sadhus and the devotees and the Srimad Bhagavatam, we can enter into that pastimes. So that is the glory of Srimad Bhagavatam. So one shall not take this Srimad Bhagavatam so cheaply. And also, so many Vaishnava Acharyas, when they have written so many different books, sometimes many times we have this understanding that those books are higher than Srimad Bhagavatam. But no, it's not like that. All the books which Vaishnava Acharyas have written, they in the writings they established Srimad Bhagavatam as a topmost literature. And they glorify all the other books are meant for glorifying, or they are the commentaries of Srimad Bhagavatam. So they are all Srimad Bhagavatam. One should not think that, oh, these books are greater than Bhagavatam. That is an offense. Because Krishna Sudhama Pagate Dharma Gyana Divisa Kalau Nashtam Rashadesha Puranar Kodrana is the Krishna is Srimad Bhagavatam. Krishna is present in this age of Kali in the form of Srimad Bhagavatam. So many times people say that these books, the writings of the Acharyas are greater than Srimad Bhagavatam. No, this is a concocted idea. It is not like that. Everything is for explaining Srimad Bhagavatam. It's like commentaries. Yes, there are some pastimes which might not be mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam. There are some additional pastimes like in Gopal Champu and other literatures. But in principle, those Gopal Champu is also Srimad Bhagavatam. What is Srimad Bhagavatam? The book where Lord's activities form pastimes of his devotees and the Supreme Lord are mentioned, that is Bhagavatam. So Gopal Champu, Ujjwala Nilamani, Lagu Bhagavatamrita, and all other books, which has the glories of the Lord and his activities and forms and pastimes, is also Srimad Bhagavatam. So it is like, so this is the definition of Bhagavatam. So whatever I could say. If we have any questions, we can take. Granthraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki.